Separation by phase creation. As you can imagine, we are going to be creating a second phase in order to favor the separation or the exchange of compositions between phases. The most common separation technique creates a second phase. As the name implies, it creates another phase, which is typically immiscible with the feed phase. So we have our feed, typically will be liquid or a mixture between liquid and vapors. And what we're going to be doing is adding heat right here in the reboiler and removing heat here in the condenser. So technically this is a ESA, energy separating agent present. We are not adding external material, so there is no MSA present. So that's what you will typically encounter in phase creation. Typically you will have ESA providing the second phase or third phase. Common operations of this type will be distillation, which involves the transfer of species between vapor and liquid phases, exploiting differences in volatilities. For instance, here we're exploiting the vapor pressure, which can be changed with temperature, technically speaking, the heat that we are removing and adding in the condenser and reboilers. Crystallization is also a good example in which you take all the way the let's say the liquid, and you end up with crystals in the supersaturated case. Or if you're talking about crystallization of solid pellets, where you have your solid, you heat it up and they will crystallize, forming a second phase.